Yes. We both sigh with relief when we hear the results. What results? It was. I'm not the only one who's been worrying about Chizuru. Teacher, Asuka, Lucia. Yeah, I did everything I could to get eaten by a fucking dinosaur.
What? What was that fucking... what?
Demo, Shizuru-chan wa dekiru koto nara anata wo mou kiken na me ni awasetaku nakattan janai kashira.
Oh, really? I couldn't tell. Really? Huh. What made you think that?
Anata no kiyoku wo keshita no ga Shizuru-chan datta to shitara.
That's right. Shizuru erased my memories. I can only think of one reason why she would do that. Because you're stupid.
今のあの子を見ていると、どういう気持ちか?
I kind of can tell. Odds are no one expected us to both be saved, since neither of us knew what happened. She sacrificed herself to save me, then made me forget everything. That would make it easier for the one being saved. She knew it was better to wipe herself out completely. Sensei?
何?
We talked about happiness before, remember? I get the feeling. We made someone else unhappy. I still don't know who. The voice said goodbye to me. When she said goodbye, I'm not sure why, but I felt like I'd never be able to make her happy. Whoever that was, she's probably been given nothing but misfortune. Sad. Like, you, any of you care? Honest to God. Everyone in this road, like, Kotori, who? Who? Shizuru probably feels it's best if she bears all the misery. She probably did want to completely erase my memories of her. Kotori deserves better.
もしそれを拒んでばかりいたら本当の幸せにはたどり着けなくなっちゃうんじゃないかしら。
That's true, but...
利己的であることが必要なのよ。でもそのことで悩むことができる人間なら思っちゃうかしらね。
Yeah, I think so too. Maybe Shizuru is like that. In which case, sorry. And goodbye. Whoever you are, I'm sure you kept us together. Get fucked. Have fun dying. What the fuck? It's just really weird. It's so fucking weird in this story where it's like, oh my god, I'm so sad. Oh my god, Kotori. And then it's like, huh? Why would I do anything to, like, talk to her, huh? Fuck that. It's crazy. It's actually insane to me. I go into Shizuru's room. I could have sworn we were underground. Huh. She's crouched down, rummaging through the fridge. Shizuru? I walk up to her, no reaction. Instead, I hear some music. I look at her ear. She has her headphones in. Hey! I wave my hand at the top of her vision, range of vision. She sees it and turns around. Her cheeks go red and, no, you scared me. Ah, you idiot, don't do that. Sorry. Jeez, keep acting cocky and I'll pound your face into a pulp with a sock full of coins. She starts taking off her socks. Ew. Obviously, I'm making that up. By the way, putting coins into a sock produces a powerful weapon, much like the ancient Chinese meteor hammer. So don't try it at home. Well, at least you seem okay. Though your face is still a bit pale, you should get some more sleep. So many S's so similar together. She returns to bed without complaint. I pull up a chair near the bed and sit down. She goes quiet for a moment. Sorry, I say almost without thinking. I've been causing nothing but trouble for you. I bury my face into my knees. I really can't do anything. True. Shizuru puts a hand on my shoulder. She pulls me up. She looks straight at me. She's smiling. She's trying to tell me it's all right. There, she pats my head. It really does make everything feel better. Thank goodness. I can still live with Shizuru. We can still have a nice, peaceful life together. Wonder why. My chest feels warm.
Warm.
Feels like part Shizuru is inside me. Why?
Strange sensation.
Thank you, Kotaro.
I felt like a voice.
Shizuru, did you say something?
Kotori, please!
She shakes her head.
Really?
As she shakes her head, Shizuru looks lonely for a moment. She's worried that I'm hearing things. Then I better change the subject.
Oh, you're still using this?
This? Shizuru takes out her iPod.
Yeah, that.
She gives me a thumbs up.
She's a total music addict now.
Glad to hear it.
I look at the screen. She was listening to slightly outdated pop. So this is what she likes.
How about this one?
I choose a song and take it one earbud.
Yeah, there it is.
This takes me back. Memories from middle school come back, making me a bit sentimental. That's not a very good reaction. She lowers her head.
Zira, do you like ballads?
She shakes her head.
Then maybe this one.
I choose a different song.
This one's about a robot who is left all alone on a faraway planet.
It desperately waits for one it loves, shouting that it's human.
Kind of like me right now.
When I think about it, tears almost come out.
Am I a human?
If my power causes my body to change into something else, will I still be human?
No, will I still have a heart and soul of one?
I thought this was a great song.
She looks troubled.
Yeah, maybe the song fucking sucks, dude.
I don't know. Maybe she's enjoying other songs, not changing it to other fucking genres.
No good? She shakes her head again and smiles. She gives me a thumbs up.
I see. She doesn't like it.
Well, music is full of acquired tastes.
Or maybe it's a bad song.
Okay, I've got to go sleep now. I've come here to visit. I only came here to visit. She tucks on my sleeve. Okay, then. I sit back down again. She hands me an apple. And a knife. Want me to peel it? She nods twice. The easiest way to do this is to cut it into pieces, then peel each piece, but... Guess I should peel the whole thing at once. I really don't think that's the case. I feel like being able to cut it in like one giant go is better, but... Hey, everyone does it differently. I prepare myself. I know, it's really stressful to peel an apple. But still. I'm not very good at this. It's just an apple. I can do it if I have to, but it's not going to look amazing. For now, I put the knife to the apple. Oh. The skin comes off much smoother than I expected. Yeah, it's just an apple, dude. It's not that hard. Whoa. I slide it around the apple. This knife is ultra sharp. It cuts a while, I accidentally cut out a large chunk. It's tough. Okay, maybe I've just peeled apples a lot. I complete my lopsided apple. It's the best I could do. There's a giant dent in one side. Well, you eat that part. Shizuru takes part of the peel where I screwed up and bites into the juicy part. So I know it's a waste, but I'll still eat this part. It's fine, she seems unsatisfied. What is it? Here, she hands me a fork.
A fork?
I have one already. It's an apple. She points to herself. Want me to eat you? She hits me in the shoulder several times. It doesn't hurt. I'm kidding. So you want me to feed you? She nods. Okay. Guess I'm fine with that. Why are you using a fork? Why does this feel so embarrassing? I suddenly remember what happened in the forest. I said I loved her. Shizuru said she loved me too. The logical conclusion is now that we are now lovers. Now we must prove it. Is this some kind of ritual? Actually, I did feed her celery once before, but this time feels completely different. Why am I even? Yeah, because it's an apple.
Why am I even worrying about this stupid thing, you might ask? Yeah, I am. This is actually really tough. No, it's not. I stick the fork into the apple. Okay, say ah. Shizuru opens her mouth. Gibberish phrases like, happy, awkward, 17, boy.
What?
Race through my mind. All skills required a certain number of experience points to master. Video game logic. It's just... my mouth opens just a little. I want to savor this moment. After that, we talked to Guardian about what happened in the forest. That was more like an interrogation. The two men gave me a barrage of questions and scribbled furiously when I answered. I did my best to remember what happened and answered clearly. The familiars I saw in the forest. Including the one in the end which almost killed me. The one that looked like a T-Rex.
The Earth Dragon.
A heavy silence falls. Even I know that was a very dangerous creature. Kashima Sakura.
Oh!
No one else could command that one that advanced.
But she's in no condition.
There aren't any other summoners with that power. They mutter to each other, too quietly for me to hear clearly.
That will be all. You can go now.
It felt like they were talking about something more important. But there is one thing still bugging me. There's one thing I haven't mentioned yet.
What is it?
There's a rainbow swamp in the forest. Who gives a fuck about that? We receive reports of similar places throughout the world. What is it exactly? Power spot. One of those utterly uninterested, but the other answers my question. Where of that? That's caused by a power spot altering the water. A power spot? The man explained it to me. Power spots are places where the Earth's energy, the life of the planet, gushes out onto the surface. Several of them have been observed across the world, but no one knows where they are. One power spot was found near Kazumatsuri. Even though it's a kind of life energy, it's harmful to humans. It made sense when I considered what happened to the over-fertilized trees. Yeah. And Gaia is sucking up that energy with tree familiars. Which means... the plant's life force is drying up. I remember those trees. They attacked me when I got too close. Since Gaia is trying to destroy the world, okay, those tree familiars are like killing two birds with one stone. They suck up the Earth's life force as well as attack people. I'm told Guardian will assemble a team to destroy them immediately. But if Gaia has been doing that all around the world, what will happen if they suck up all the energy? The plant will literally die. Yeah. I don't know, dude. Maybe you should have gone back to class and remember what Guy is actually trying to do, and then you'd be like, oh, that doesn't make sense. I remember what the swamp looked like in Shiver. We had to stop that from happening. I'm annoyed that I can't do anything myself. Don't worry, a guardian exists to stop them. Yeah, which came first, the guardian or the egg? Yes. I had to leave all of that to these guys. It'll be fine. The world won't be destroyed that easily. Humanity's not weak. Okay. That's why I think at least.
Soka. Yogo wa ryōkō ka. Nani yori da.
Sorry about everything.
Watashi ni ayamatta tokoro de shikata ga nai. Konkai no ken wa keisotsu na kōdō ni yoru mono da. Igo tsutsushime.
I'll remember that.
鉄拳制裁もなしか。甘やかされてるね。
今宮、貴様に隊員でもない身の上で少女を助けるために危険な森へ単身乗り込むなどできるのか？
いえ、できんでしょうね。
賢いのだな。
そういうふうに教わりましたんで。
I can't tell if he's praising me for something or not.
今回はいい。
Probably not.
だが、以後は私の管轄下に入ってもらう以上、一切の迂闊さは捨てろ。
Yes. His words feel much stricter this time. As being a total idiot this time, he has every right to be mad at me. I'm just glad him being mad at me is the only consequence.
ま、お手柄だよ。
え？
森に結界があったんだ。認識を阻害する類の。それに気づいて、ガイアの連中はもう動いてた。ほっとけばそのまま確保されてたろうよ。あんたらの騒動で少なくともそれは防ぐことができたからさ。
Sad. Captured what?
聞いていなかったか？鍵のことだ。
え？言っちゃってよかったんですか？
構わん。何より天王寺はすでに接触している唯一の人間だ。
What's the key?
前にあんたから報告にあったやつだよ。
And Mamiya flips through the files in his hand.
リボンを回せる少女。鍵はそういう形態を取ってるみたいだな。
That's the girl I saw in the forest a few months ago. She definitely felt dangerous that time, but she still looked human though. What'd she do?
あれは人ではない。魔物だ。最悪の魔物だ。
One of the worst kind? I've only seen monsters so far, so I can't imagine it.
通常、鍵は常人には認識できぬよう、ある種の魔物が持つ能力を使用している。
I'm glad they're like, not mentioning Kotori was there, but you know what, whatever. Like camouflage?
そうだな。で、そういうのを無視して見ることができる連中を、俺たちは目って呼んでる。すごいぜ。お前、もう将来は安泰だ。
極めて特殊な才能だ。今後君には見る役目を負ってもらうことになるかもしれない。
I'm not sure I understand, but being able to see that girl is special.
破格の待遇が待ってるってこった。羨ましい話だね。
Is the key bad?
そこも知らなかったのかよ。ガイアは知ってんだろ？
Yeah, I think so.
あいつらの競技は世界の破滅だよ。
I've heard that part.
人間世界の破滅って言った方がいいかな。やつらはそのジョージのために鍵を探してんのさ。
Okay. That girl can destroy the world? It's hard to believe.
そういう資料が残ってんのさ。街が一つ瞬時に消滅したとかな。
Wow, a whole city?
さもなきゃ。あちらさんが躍起になって森を探し回ってる理由が説明つかないんじゃねえの？
鍵をあやつらの手に渡すわけにはいかん。即時に討伐しなければならんのだ。
If you say so. Doesn't feel real. That girl destroying the world.
だがガイアが魔物を操り、世界制覇でも目論むだけのカルト集団なら、我々はこんな組織で対抗したりせんよ。それと君が見ている範囲より、我々ははるかに大きい組織だ。
Yeah, there's like whole 18 members.
バチカン本部に世界中で活動してんのよ。
Your fucking headquarters is a joke.
ま、俺らは人類を滅びから守るために動いてる。だからガーディアンなのさ。伊達や水郷でやってると思われちゃ迷惑だぜ。でけえ話だ。だからこそ汚い話だっていっぱいある。わからねえならどうするか。もう一回よく考えてみな。俺たちは少なくともみんなを守る正義のヒーローじゃない。
Yeah, I know you aren't.
ただの人の生きる権利ってやつを守るための権利団体さ。
Doubt. Icky details.
普通の人ならやりたくないこと。争いって言って、それ以上詳しく言わねえとわからんかねえ、坊ちゃんには。普通は相手の戦う理由だの、主義主張なんざ聞いてる暇なんてねえ。漫画じゃねえんだ。効率よくやんのさ。
Yeah, that's the only thing that's different. I can imagine what he's getting at. Super people fighting summoners, it's more than just badass fights. They're killing each other.
考えんなら早い方がいい。ここの町はもう戦闘区域だ。鍵は現状、どっちも確保できてない。ここだっていつ襲われるかわからんってこと。じゃあ、頑張んな、候補生さんよ。
Yeah, he pats me on the shoulder and leaves the room. His hand is really stiff. It almost felt like he hit me with a chunk of metal.
すまんな。今見はあれで優秀な男だが、現状で気を尖らせているのも無理はない。
I am less than pleased with this situation. It's fine. But do you guys actually need me?
そうだな。必要とされる人間だ。何よりしずる君にとってもだろう。歳だろうか。なぜか君らには毒気を抜かれてしまう。今宮の言う通り、鉄拳の一つや二つ飛ばしていてもおかしくはないのだが。
It's okay, I'm really glad you're not.
殴られるのは嫌かね。
No, I do not.
だろうな。だが、嫌がるなら君はここでおとなしくしているべきだ。
That sounds blaming a victim there.
なぜだかは知らないが、目を持つ者が君を鍵かと錯覚した。が、原因を追求している時間はない。だが君は我々にとって有用な存在になり得るし、また危険な存在なのかもしれん。
I mean, if there's continuity between the routes, Kotori being captured, i.e. killed, probably, because, you know, Guardian shoots on sight, doesn't ask questions. I should be, like, dead by now.
事実、ここへ魔物が現れたという報告もある。 二匹の小さいものだったということだが、石膏かもしれん。通常ガイアで使われる我々が波長と呼ぶようなものではなかったとのことだが、
Gil and Penny?
まさか君の意思で我々に害をなすことはないと思うがね。
No, I'm not sure what to do with me. I did used to be friends with people from Gaia, and I haven't been formally trained by Guardian like the others. I can only handle being hit at least.I've been through a near-death experience already.
そうか。だが今はおとなしくしていたまえ。外に出るくらいは構わんが。
I like the idea of staying fucking home. That sounds nice and peaceful.
奴らが活発に動くのは夜だが、そうも言っておれんだろう。気をつけることだな。
I... Yes. Salute. Shizuru? She's asleep.She probably won't wake up for a while. I sit down on a chair next to her bed. I look at her face. Ah. I smile from ear to ear. No, I'm feeling too peaceful. Still, I can't wake her up. Esuka said I could go outside, but I don't want to. That's right. The song she didn't like earlier. I feel like a little prank. Oh yeah, I'm only going to play the song she doesn't like because I'm fucking...cool like that. Pranked. I beg a nearby person to borrow their laptop. After explaining what I want it for, he helps me find a microphone to plug it into. Into it. It better make her happy. Will do, thank you very much. He cheers me on. Now time to just sing it, I guess, because that... Uh-huh. Funny. Fuck.The adjacent room is empty, so I borrow for a little while. I make a music file and put together all the songs I like. It's an OG selection. Now for the important part. I guess this is kind of a love letter. A love letter to Shizuru. I hook up the mic and some recording software. I clear my throat, wait a few seconds, and click the recording button. To Shizuru. I can't do anything for you, but I decided to do this since I thought it might make you happy. I run out of ideas. Great. Please like this. I know I'm making an idiot of myself. That's right, music. That's right, you know, after listening to music for a long time, I start learning to like songs I don't care for at first. It's kind of nice when that happens. If I listen to a song I really like too much, it'll be in my head constantly and I'll misspeak. Shizuru, if we could be together forever, I'd like it if something like that...Yeah, that was bad. Forget I said that. I feel like rolling around on the floor. Well, you get the point. So that's why I put together all these love songs. Now listen to this with all my love. And then I sang. There's nothing I can do about the stuff I said earlier. This is a live recording. You can just stop recording, delete it, and then do it again. Finished. Why was I singing? Well, everyone says I suck at singing, but maybe I did decently that time. Love should improve singing just like it does cooking. It doesn't. Well, I guess it'd be too embarrassing to say this to you in person, so I chose that song, so I could put as much of my feelings into it as possible. I'd be really happy if you listened to it over and over. I want you to know that's how I feel when I'm around you. If anything, it might be nice to listen to it together. I think I'd like listening to songs with you that we both enjoy. Anyways, that was Tenoji's best selection of love songs. Please enjoy it. I click the stop button. Done. The audio file is complete. There are lots of problems with the content, but it should be enough to surprise her at least. Maybe I should listen to it just to check. No, I'd probably want to kill myself. Yep. But I do want to see your reaction to it, so I put that on the top of the folder. The songs after this are what I actually selected. Now I just wait until Shizuru finds this. This really is all I can do. But I want to keep doing things like this to make her happy. I don't know how many more I'll come up with. Maybe 10, maybe 100, but I'll do them all. And I want to watch Shizuru enjoy it forever. I put the iPod back next to Shizuru as she sleeps. Okay, now what? You said I could go out, but is it really okay to just wander out alone? On the outside, this is just a department store. Even if they see me come out, that shouldn't make them suspect anything under the building. That's right. I just didn't remember something I need to do. I need to jerk off. It's been a week. I'm definitely heading out now. Good daytime. I've been underground so long, I've been having trouble telling time. They have windows in there. What are you talking about? I feel something. I don't think it's an enemy, but... Wait. Not sure, but I think I know this. Gil, Penny, is that you? No answer. Sorry about what I said earlier. I really did forget everything. Yeah, I can't blame you for holding it against me. But it's best if you don't follow me anyway. You're familiars, after all. I still have no idea what you guys are, but it was fun having me around. Take care of yourselves. What the hell? Don't be selfish. That's true. Though I'm still completely useless. Sorry. After that, I didn't hear anything else. Good talk.